You must have played it 100 times, you was going to bed. Why would I put on a vest? I expected an aim for the head. I could have killed you the first time. You don't have to try and say it louder, nigga. Trust me, heard you the first time. It's not the first time. I would have done it to anyone. And I blame where I came from. And I blame all my day ones. You know, chubs like Draymond. You better hope not saying none. Young boys, they're here for
you. Almost at school.
Tell anyone in your friend group.
Okay.
I beat the living fucking shit out of Cam.
You did?
Yeah.
Like you beat him up?
Yeah. Well, I didn't like beat him up. I got him in a headlock and I kept him down.
What did you do?
You know in Goonie Redux, those videos that Sebastian sang?
Yeah.
It got really fucking heated.
Shit.
And I dragged him out and then I got him in a headlock and he started screaming help, 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 help in the parking lot.
You guys, like, not friends anymore?
Yeah. And if you look at all his tweets, it's all about me. Every single retweet and tweet's about me. And I drove him home and everything after that, too.
That's why you're parking over here.
I figured I'd just leave that over there.
And I have to film these kids. Drive to school.
I'm not in the wrong.
Yeah.
Sebastian was there and he saw it. He was like, he was fucking with your car too much.
Yeah.
And he's like, you're gonna take me home.
Nah.
Some guy even came too.
Really?
Yeah. But he didn't do anything.
I'm kind of glad I didn't kill it now.
Yeah.
No, I can't use my windshield wipers!
Why does it only rain on my car?
Oh, it was raining on mine too.
Okay, I thought I was alone.
This is where Jane parks.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you're lucky to see this.
Huh?
Alright, I think that's good recording.
Two, three. Hello, and welcome to the Cameron Bender documentary. This is about the Chaparral High School. Right now, we're on our path to Chaparral High School, where we will untell the story of students at Chaparral High School, with the pains and struggles of them, the idiocracy that goes on in the boys' bathrooms, the sexism on the streets. It's really insane. But right now, we're on the path of the traffic, where they like to play tardy sweeps, and they play music, and if you don't make it to your class when the music's done, you're sent to a different class for your period and you miss your learning. Right now, this is probably the early stages of traffic, so we're not gonna really hit the climax until we hit the centerpiece of going into Chaparral High School. So, right now, we're just taking our nice little path. I'm going 45, oh no, that's a red light. But yeah, we're gonna keep going. See, there's the short bus. Kids. And this old lady trying to drive. I think that's my dad over there. I don't really know. Yep, still at this red light. Yeah, still at this red light.
You?
Yeah, green light. Look at that. It's our lucky day. use that term, I'm just trying to be PC and cool with the kids. PC, political correctness. Maybe you didn't learn that in school from the shit education. Oops, excuse my language, I gotta blurt that out. Now we're at it. Oh, this guy sells bonsai trees. Maybe that's what causes traffic. Him standing in the middle of the road, selling bonsai trees. Now we're gonna go. Possibility is the sun going up. It's only 6:38. I probably hit the early bird. But we'll feel it soon. Usually I get to school around 7:05. Really crowded, so the kids decide to wake up at that same time as me. Probably 6:43 and go to school. We're driving. I'd have music on and all that, but I forgot my mic at home. I was gonna say work, I don't know why. I'm just a 17-year-old boy. Wow, I'm 17 now. My birthday was last month, and no one said happy birthday to me. Talking about daily life values. Yeah, nothing happened just right now, besides some guy trying to cut me off. So we're going. See, a lot of people are getting up now because they're getting up at the time of 6:43. Well, it's 6:39, but they're hitting the pre-early stages. Soon we'll be encountering all the people going to school. For instance, these cars, they're all going to be taking the same term. Then we're going to be going to the shortcut where cops like to crack down on us and give us tickets or sometimes arrest those students. Yeah, police violence is sometimes real. It's just because we're retards. There's no such thing as police brutality unless you instigate it. Maybe besides the Ferguson theme, because that was actually a serious deal. But we're gonna keep going in these cars. They like to merge in front of me.
Go food? Cook breakfast?
No, I don't want to grab food.
Why would you cook it like that?
I didn't cook it like that. I gave you a raw.
I know. Boy. No, I'm trying to get the
finish filming. So we're gonna take our nice little shortcut. Probably gonna have to stop food now and probably end my documentary because someone's hungry.
How are you not hungry?
Because I eat food in the morning.
Fuck you, man. You have food? I'm a poor boy.
Focus filming. We're about to get to the police crackdowns. As you can see here is the daily struggles. Hollywood Sebastian, let's read this.
Just another character.
Oh, cool. I finally figured out what my character is in this one video game of play. Just another character. Oh no, my music. That's some gang related stuff. Don't want to listen to that. Going through the neighborhood. Just gonna be driving. Oh wait, I'm supposed to go 424 here. I'm still at my house soon. I'm throwing a house party. Like an end of the year house party. Yeah, people should come.
This is for your project?
Yeah.
Yeah. Weird.
That's from the project. Well, just as a reminder, this is the 20% time project for English 11. The documentary's name is Chaparral High School, Struggles of the Young Student by Cameron Bender. Directed, edited, displayed by Cameron Andrew Bender. But back on track now. Coming to the point. Oh, I could have almost got pulled over. I got really scared for a second. I wasn't paying attention. But back on track, we're going to the point where we're gonna get going, hitting 35 real fast when you get down to the other side. As you can see here, here's another kid walking. He probably won't make it to school in time by probably 7:20. Then they're gonna probably play that Target Sweep song I liked. What's that, Justin Timberlake song? The Happy song? No,
okay, that's a Pharrell Williams.
I don't know, but I think the same exact song is Pharrell Williams. They're gonna play that, the Justin Timberlake song. They're gonna play that. This kid's gonna probably get in immense trouble. He's gonna miss his first period class. Not be able to do anything. Miss out on his education. Speeding up a bit because I only have 2 minutes left on my camera's time clock for filming. But right now we're just hitting about the point. It's probably gonna end by the time I get to the point where everything's gonna happen. So I'm gonna have to make a new film, put a nice little transition of the Grand Canyon, and top it off with a nice good documentary. So we're driving. I would put my music on because I wanna feel like a hype beast. That's what some kids at school like to listen to. It's really bad language and all that. Dunkin' Donuts, I'll just show an example. I listen to country like Blake Shelton, Keith Urban, and Carrie Underwood. I retract my last statement. I said I don't want to be a hype beast. I don't want to be a hype beast. I want to be a good education student. Now, here we are at the traffic point of all traffic points. And it's probably hearing at the last 30 seconds, I'm guessing.
You've got a minute.
I got a minute, yeah, here we go. Oh. Okay, so maybe it's not that bad right now, but it gets pretty bad. Oh no, yellow light. Oh no, too fast. But as you can see, okay.
You got 30.
So yeah, here's the parking lot. Yeah, you can probably see the parking lot. No one's really here yet. It's probably because it's not, oh wow, it just turned 6:43. Look at that.
What?
Yeah.
All right, it's over.
All
right. 5, 4, 3, 2.
So what do you think of Shap so far ever since you came?
I like it. It's a new experience for me from private school to public school, but overall it's good.
What do you think of the bathroom crisis?
That's disgusting.
I only have one.
That's gross. It's just because then everyone has to go in that one and it messes all over the place.
What do you think of the education here? Is it on par with your private school?
There are some things that are higher from my private school, and then there are some things that were lower. Since it's just a difference of education between them.
Was it easier to get friends, like, cause since you're coming to a new school?
No, like, it was harder.
It was hard?
Yeah.
Yeah. But you feel like you blend in now?
Yeah, I feel like I'm part of
Shap, yeah. You got some good friends.
Yeah.
Are you doing any sports or anything?
No.
Do you plan on doing any sports?
Maybe.
All right. Well, what do you think of like the sports system, like athletes and all that? Like, do you think there's enough funding from what you've seen?
I couldn't tell you because I haven't played any sports. But right.
Is it easier getting into the parking lot or is it hard to get out? Like, well, what should people know? Like, for like, if it's backed up or like, is like, what should they do if it's just too crowded?
They should take their time.
Take their time.
I feel everyone's rushing out at 1 minute, and then that's how that accident happened.
Alright, well thank you for your time.
Yeah, no problem.
Nick Anderson. So what's it like coming to Shap?
What's it like? It's pretty new. Not well diverse as my last one. Yeah.
What was your last school's education like compared to ours?
This is probably better than my last school. The last school was again with school.
So it was probably more diverse there because there's a mix of culture here. This is just like, it's in one city and not many.
Yeah.
What do you think of the bathroom crisis? How there's only one bathroom? Yeah.
Not all of them works. When one's fixed, one gets broken. Same goes like every day.
True, true. All right. Do you plan on doing any sports?
Any sports right now? No.
Not ever?
No.
Alright, well, what do you think of the traffic jam?
Traffic jam?
In the school parking lot.
That's disgusting.
It is?
Yeah.
Yeah. What should you say to other students?
What do I say?
Yeah, for getting out and all that.
Like, get out, 5 minutes before the bell rings, because that's what I do sometimes. I just get out of the class, so I don't get stuck in traffic.
Okay. Yeah. Anything you want to say at all? Just anything about Shap? You can say it sucks. You can say I said that. I said it sucks.
It kind of is. Shap is Shap. That's what I get, I guess.
Alright.
Yeah.
So let's see what does the TVUSD Twitter page follow? PE Clevery, Inland Code, RCOE, Go HS Red Wave. Great Oak Athletics, Riverside Sheriff, Wolfpack Spirit, Great Oak Baseball, TVHS Bears Baseball, TVH PTSA, Great Oak High School, TVHS Band, High School Game Time, PE, Temecula Ed Foundation, Temecula Council, PTA. Where's Chaparral High School? Where is Shap on this page? Oh wow, there's no Shap. As expected. Okay, so what grade are you? What grade are you?
I'm a junior.
Alright. What do you like about the school?
It's very tolerant of specific sets of people, race, etc. Teachers are really nice most of the time. Not too unreasonable, but what I don't like is some teachers don't teach. And they just hand you packets and expect you to get something out of it rather than actually teaching. So that's pretty much all I don't like about the school.
Can you explain more why you don't like the school from that perspective?
I can't learn if no one teaches a specific subject, especially if I don't like the subject. Like, for example, taking biology because it's a requirement.
Who was your bio teacher?
Miss Emery.
Oh.
She just, most of the time we're doing labs, or she's sitting at that computer, and she hands us piles and piles of packets.
Do you know about the pipe leak at the school?
Pipe leak?
Yeah, the one for the bathroom.
No. Yeah, the maintenance can be a pretty bad problem. People lighting fires in the bathroom and pot smokers.
Yeah.
It smells like skunk.
Did you know what kind of pipe the pipe was used for the bathroom?
Was it used?
It was just plastic pipe for hot water.
For hot water?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's smart.
Yeah.
It's really smart. Right. No, don't. Yeah, I don't like that. I didn't hear about that, but now I have.
That's what the school's like.
Right now, because my mom's arguing with me, obviously you can hear that. But still, then stop doing that. Stop. Okay, I'm keeping this because I need time. And this is going to be probably the A1 effort. But yeah, back on track. I've been looking around the school. I've been interviewing people for my 20% time project. That is a project that was assigned to us by Ms. Charney. And this is going to go over the improvements that could be possible to the school. This is going over stuff that's on campus that should be fixed. It's going to, I want it to reach out to the community or the administration or the Unified School District or maybe Ms. Dias or the teachers. But I want to know what's going on in the school. Like, I want people to know what's going on the campus. Like, how there's only two guy bathrooms. Oh, there's a lot of old equipment. Some sports stuff is from still the 90s or something. But, like, there's just stuff that should be here and useless stuff should go away. It should, like, I want, like, this is the voice of the students and what should be used. And I think that's that. Is that what I said in the beginning? Yeah, okay.
Hello. My name's Cameron
Andrew Bender.
I'm the director of this project, a.k.a. Bendopolis 3, the documentary. And I'm here to give the full view of how bad Shap is and improvements can be made. For instance, one of the guys' bathrooms by the 300s was set on fire and blown up. We only had two bathrooms.
It was the 400s.
It was the 400s? Yeah, okay, well, it's the 400s. The bathroom by the weight room had a murder incident where someone literally shat blood.
How about that sinkhole?
Oh, yeah. And then we have a plastic pipe that contains hot water wired to the bathroom. You know how much, like, poo and piss goes through that? That's just funny. And bananas and avocados. Kids like to do that. The other day I found kale and a vegan patty in the sink. So, yeah, that was pretty fun. What else can I add? Oh, yeah. The bathrooms in the 700 building upstairs is locked. And then the one on the bottom, the guys is locked, but the girls isn't. I think that's kind of really sexist. Ms. Dias, I'm calling you out on that. You are sexist. You can expel me after this. Honestly, don't care. But you're sexist, Ms. Dias. I don't care. You can honestly refute me on that, but you are a sexist. Okay, so we have the weight room's bathroom, the 400's bathroom, the locker room bathroom that we can't even use because we can't go to the locker room because it's not a period. Honestly, that's our only bathrooms, isn't it? Ms. Dias, you're sexist. Girls have three bathrooms. No, four. They have two more than us.
Quad, weight room, 400, 700.
We don't have the 700. I'm saying is they're locked, so we only have two. Yeah. So, you're sexist, Ms. Dias. Another thing that could be improved is probably the education. Where's my auto shop? Where's wood shop?
Coach Carey.
Oh, that's with Carey?
Yeah, state check.
Yeah, but, okay, honestly, do they really learn how to do that stuff? Yeah. what else? The equipment. Like, seriously, like, some of the sports, literally, water polo has a ball from the 70s, I think.
Sports are way under budget.
Yeah, sports are way under budget. I honestly feel like football's taking money, but honestly,
I don't care.
We actually need the improvement. What else? Also, cyberbullying is really not a thing. People, like, I don't know why the school tries to focus on cyberbullying. I think they should focus on inside the school. Because honestly, seriously, there's bullying going on and all that. And it's not even for on cyberbullying at all. It's, like, literally, like, face-to-face and all that. So it's like, oh, yeah, don't cyberbully because we will hunt you down. It's like, what are you going to honestly do? Also, the bomb threats of our school. That should have been contained already. And someone said, oh, yeah, that's on a lockdown. Yet they evacuate us to the field and, like, to the gym. Yeah, that's on a lockdown, dude. But, yeah, this is our director's message. And the whole entire purpose of this video. And you're going to see me expose every living goddamn secret at Chaparral High School. Enjoy the ride.
They spew up bowl and they expect you to learn, or they hand out packets and expect you to learn. They don't care. They're just like there to like
as placeholders.
Oh, so you're just saying they're there to observe?
No, they're just there to be there. They're not teaching. They're not interacting with their students. They're just there. Like, they don't have any control over the classroom. They just don't do anything.
So
they don't help us. They're not doing their jobs as teachers.
So you don't think it's like a...
the quality of the teaching styles here, or just the teachers in general, is very varied in SHAP. You get go from, like, the worst, the best, in, like, one period. It's really annoying. And, like, if you get a teacher... another thing I don't like. The fact that having a teacher that has a teaching style you don't like isn't a valid reason to switch out of the class. Because it's a good reason. Because if you have a teacher that doesn't teach the way that you understand, your whole grade could be screwed. Your whole future can be screwed because a teacher doesn't know how to convey information into you. Like, the way you can interpret it. And the fact that that's not a good enough reason to go into another teacher's classroom or to go into another class, it's just dumb. Like, I've gotten screwed over with math a couple times because of this.
Is that it?
Yeah.
All right. That was very reasonable, Whit.
Can I watch, buddy?
I'm still filming. I need my director's cut, too. Hey, Ken.
Yeah. Okay, homie.
Hey, Ken. Can you come here?
No, I'm doing this.
All right, then I'll come to you. All right, Ken, what do you think of Chaparral High School? All right, come on, Ken. Hey, be quiet. All right, what do you think of Chaparral High School?
Huh?
What do you think of Chaparral High School?
It's shit.
All right, yeah, I'll take that. What do you think of Chaparral High School?
It's good.
Okay, don't lie to yourself. Don't lie to yourself. Don't lie to yourself. Be honest. Be honest.
The people here kind of suck. Teachers are nice.
Yeah. Bullshit. Almost fought Heavy Brand this morning. Teachers are not nice.
I don't
nice.
Know who that is.
You will.
And then, school campus is okay. There's a lot of trash on here.
Alright, what do you think of the Puma Press?
Now that's good stuff. That's
you guys write shit. Propaganda. You guys write propaganda. I'm gonna blatantly put that out. You write propaganda.
Everyday women culture is rape culture.
I don't care about the homophobes. Why did you put that in there?
Like, how do you think it's me personally?
It's about to be. it's about to be. It's supposed to be about school news. Not public news.
Every
Ken, do you think the homework here is trash because you're always flooded with homework and I have never have time for yourself?
Because
this is what you're doing right now.
Yep.
You can't help a friend out with his project. The struggles. So, what do you think about the Puma Press again?
That doesn't work.
It's all about the homophobes.
None of this works.
Platinum Press, homophobic, 2017. That's Platinum Press.
So, Josh, otherwise you think Shep's good?
Yeah. You're like 7 out of 10, you know.
7 out of 10, why can't it be an 8 out of 10?
How many stars?
Or a 9.
Or a 7.5.
No, let's give it like a 3.5 star rating.
Then again, Josh did rate me a 7 out of 10, so.
Then again, what do you think about Shep?
All the people here are fake.
Whoa. Like you.
Whoa.
Adding yourself.
Whoa.
Josh, you're gay.
I just got called fake. Wait, Josh, you're gay?
Yes.
No. He is
Why
gay.
Why else do you think he writes about it in the newspaper?
Is it hard to be gay on this campus?
Ask Kent.
That's me. Kent's the straightest guy I know.
Kent's as straight as his curves on the freaking paper.
Hey, at least he curve slops girls and not guys.
Oh, okay, I'm gonna leave. Bye, Kent. I don't know what I just experienced.
This guy.
I'm ready.
You've been here, you didn't even change it.
This is some good commentary. What do you think of Chaparral High School, Sky?
It's a school. It's not the best school. Definitely not the best school.
On a scale of 1 to 10, where does it lie?
Probably a 3.5.
A 3.5? Why?
Well, just pretty dirty campus overall.
For instance, the bathroom?
Well, let me finish.
All right.
The front office is extremely rude. Attendance ladies and the nurse. And just not good customer service.
So what about the bathrooms?
The bathrooms are disgusting.
How?
So there's urine on the floor. Nobody knows how to flush the toilet. For some reason, people get joy out of peeing on toilet paper and throwing it on the ground. I just feel
true.
Yeah, I know.
True.
Very.
What do you think about how many bathrooms we have?
The boys have about one working bathroom, and it's pretty sad.
It is. How do you see Miss Dace as a good principal so far? Does she live up to Compton?
No comment.
Okay. All right. Did you know Mr. Slides left this year?
Who?
All right. Our assistant principal, Mr. Slides.
Yeah, I was away.
Oh, okay. What do you think of the teachers?
There's a handful of good teachers, and the rest are kind of just there.
Like, how about Mr. Hebebrand? He was a clown. Do you think he has the right to teach?
Hebebrand's a good person. But the math is alright.
Alright. So, you're graduating a lot. Do you think the school's going to give you a good graduation or an average one?
I feel like they're going to put out for the graduation. We're going to end with a good graduation.
All right. I think that's all. Thank you for your comments.
No problem.
How do I do action? All right. What do you think of Chaparral High School?
It's an alright school.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how alright?
2.5.
A 2.5? Why?
Admin's horrible. Attendance is horrible. Counselors are great. Besides that, everything is dirty.
Like what?
The floor, classrooms, there's rats everywhere, bathrooms, locker rooms.
Yeah. What's wrong with the bathrooms?
There is a poop everywhere. Pee everywhere.
Alright. What do you think of how many bathrooms there are? Like, is there a good amount or none?
They should have one more. I'll leave the one upstairs open. 700. Well, besides that, nope.
So, anything else to add? Oh, what do you think of Miss Dace?
She's alright. Probably one of the best principals out of all of them.
Alright, what about the teachers?
Two out of six are good that I have right now. But besides that, teachers are teachers. For their job.
Alright, I think that's all. But is there anything else you want to add?
No.
Okie dokie.